Okay. Since last Father's Day, I posted the video memories of father. So I reconnected with some of my friends. I think a total of about four girls and one boy. And you know, my old classmate and some old neighbor, childhood friends. And so they all asked me to tell their father's story. Because those people, they all, this five of them, they all grew up without the father. Mm-hmm. And so I said, yes, I will, after I finish my father's story, I will tell you guys story, definitely, promise. They know I'm doing this radio program. And so I said, I want you to write the details, as detailed as you can. So today I will tell the story, the girl. And so she wrote, I had to translate it in English. So she said, those things happened 55 years ago, have been in the past for many years, and they have never been described in such detail. Somehow today, all come up. He said, probably because I just watched the Schindler's List again, the movie. He said, you know, I have always felt that people actually consider two major issues in their lives, love and hate, and the life and the death. All other issues are depend on those two major things. In particular, life and death, their coming and going, cannot be controlled by us. We have no dominate this short period of time between life and death. So live it and live it well. However, it is not easy for a person to live with dignity and to die with dignity. So now I tell about her father's story. And I met her, she was a little girl, she's my neighbor, but it's not the same building we live in, but just close by the other building. And in that time I was in elementary school, and I played the ping pong. And all the Chinese kids play ping pong because we don't have as a, you know, facility to do other sports. So ping pong is very popular. So I representing my team, so I have five people from this elementary school. She representing her school. So we always had competed, and after that we shaking hands. And she's the last one, I always the last one. So we always shaking together. So then one day I walk home and found out that she just lived nearby another building. So she said, you know, maybe we can play ping pong, you know, not just compete, just play, you know, practice. I said, yeah, that's a good idea. So we become a friend. And then I during the Cultural Revolution, I knew, you know, they say that her father was a suicide, but I really don't know the details because we never get a chance to talk about the details. And interesting enough is eventually when I left in China, even before that, and people say they moved away, and then she becoming an actress, movie actress. And I left China, she became very famous. She did a couple of movies, was big hit. And talking about the Cultural Revolution, the period, the people had a little bit of, you know, in China, that period, they allow you to talk about, but just a little bit, touch the surface, not really deep. And then, after the all, and it's kind of bothering me, they said that she just give up everything, because she's a beautiful woman, really, you know, good, I mean, famous movie star, and that she wanted to be a nun. And she did. She went to a temple, you know, the Buddhist temple. She just
dropped out.
Yeah. So this time I reconnected with her. We didn't talk about those things. She said, I asked her, why you want to, you know, give up everything in the normal life. People with, you know, you be famous and watched by lots of people and all kind of things you looking forward. Why you just think it's enough, right? And she didn't really answer. So if I know, you know, Buddhist, I know that, I studied that. If I know early, I say, I'm not even get married. She was married and divorced, you know. So it means that she was just, you know. So I think a lot to do with maybe her childhood. And she said yes. Mm. You know, I think that was back 55 years ago, 1966. And she's 2 years younger than me. And so I think probably that I was 13 and she probably 11 or something like that age. And one day, she was at home with the grandma and her sister and waiting for the mother to come home. But it was so late, probably 10 o'clock, mother's not home. And she fell, 11 years old, little girl fell, something happened. And she asked the grandma. Grandma said, "You go to bed. Don't think about that." But she said that she just couldn't go to bed, you know, because just waiting for the mother. The mother coming, and with her clothes was wet, and was very cold that night. That's what the reason she wrote. I want her to read every details. And then they have left some fried rice for the mother. And she took it, just probably a bite, and then she just put away. And then she said, "Oh, girls," she said, "they go to bed." Just put she and her younger sister to bed. And then she couldn't sleep. She just wake up and wanted to know what's really happened. So when they went to bed, and the mother come back and talked to the grandma, and she started crying, and she said, "He's dead." It means her father.
The father.
Yeah, he's dead. So the grandma said, "How did you know?" She said, "They told me. I went to the place he worked, but they said that they took him his body and to the crematory." And so she went there, and she asked the person on the door. He said, "Is that the person with inside? I want to see the last time. I brought some clothes." And then that person said, "No, you cannot see him." And because they said you had to denounce him in the public. Right now it's at 9. You cannot do that. And so she's standing, you know, in the rain. It was cold and rain. That's why her clothes are wet. And they still don't let her in. And then she coming back. So she told her mother, say her husband dead, but cannot see the last time. And but they say that the guy at the door, and you know, the doorman, and told her, say that they're not gonna cremate today. He said probably tomorrow. Say, "Why don't you ask other people?" He said, "What other people?" He said, "Like your kid. Do you have a kid?" He said, "I have a daughter." He said that people do that. If kids coming, they not let kids to see, but that they will take the stuff. Because they're not going to make a kids to denounce or anything. Yeah. So anyway, so she was in a bed. I'm talking my friend. I had to say her name is Rainbow. And she was in bed. She heard everything. And so the mother come into her room and said, "How can you still not sleep?" He said, "I can't sleep. I know everything. I heard everything." And the mother said, "Okay." Then say that tomorrow you go. Then this is the father's clothes. You just take the clothes. And she said, "Okay." She on the sun for that moment. She said she probably 11 years old. So on the sun, she become a doll.
Yeah.
You know, because
absolutely.
She think that this is a major responsibility and job for her to do. But she said that right now she remembered. That's how I want her to write everything, what she think, all the details. She said that that moment, and that she felt, and this news coming, it's not really shock because it's expected. Because before that, for many days, she was having nightmare about that happen. But it happened. You know, doesn't matter. She wake up, oh, this is a dream. I hope it never gonna happen. But it's happened, right? And then so next day, she took a bus, carry her father's story and the shoes, socks, everything, and to the crematory. So they also 30 yuan. You had to pay. And so they probably will give her the ash. That's 30 yuan for.
Mm-hmm.
And so she got there. She was shocked because so many kids waiting outside. So she's not
instead
only
of,
one.
Instead of the
parents, you know, whatever. Wow. Yeah, all kids. And so she got there. She had to wait. It's so cold. She still remembered it 55 years later. She said that it was so cold, just cold up to your heart. Right now she remembered that, still can feel the chills. And then she just standing there in line in the ring, and see this, you know, when you criminal, you know, the people they burn, so you constantly you see the chimney, the huge big chimney, and just boom, you know, and the sound, and then the one of those smoke come out. That's one body, that's another body. So she's just counting, and finally, probably almost 2 hours. And she say she count up, just countless, you know, just boom, boom, boom.
Too many,
you know,
to count.
Too many, yeah. And then the guy, the old guy, the doorman that opened the door, he said, come in, little girl. He said, did you bring anything? He said, yes, I did. He said, do you have the from the company, you know, which, the name?
Yeah.
And she wrote it down. She gave it a piece of paper. She said that was. So the guy said, you wait here, said. So you go there, look at, because they cannot get her in to look at, you know. And he wait. He said, that's probably the longest way in her life. Finally, the guy come out and tell her, he said, he threw up everything. Probably took some pills.
Mm.
Then, is that right? He asked the girl. So she just nodded. And then he said, then, don't tell your mother. And his ear and been torn apart and then hanging in the face. But don't tell your mother. He said, just be nice to your mother. You go home. So it took this 30 and said, I will give you the ash. They're going to do processing now, he said. So anyway.
Wow, that's so sad.
Yeah, you know. So.
But you said too many people to count.
Too many people to count.
Well, she waited.
All the kids just standing. So I wonder, I was touched so, 55, I know her father passed away, you know, I mean, suicide, and I know 55 years, but to today, when I read what she wrote about, the details, I still just can't help cry.
Yeah, we see it in her face.
Yeah, just so, you know, sad, you know, but that's the way it is. And then she had to, next day, I think, she got the ash and took the ash and take the train farther from northern China and to in her village, his village where he born. So they put it in the soil, you know. In the home village, yeah. So he's alone. And that time she say she just grow up. All of a sudden she become, that mission she had to do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. In Sendai. her mother.
1 minute she's a little girl, and the next minute she's an adult.
Yeah, yeah, just like
yeah.
That.
Yeah. Wow.
So yeah.
Hey, Amy, folks, we can see Amy's face when she's mm-hmm. when she told the story, and it's not. It's a very painful experience, and it wasn't even her family that she's talking about. But
yeah.
because you know from personal experience what the experience was like for that friend of yours and yeah. the entire family,
yeah,
you know why it's so sad. And I think we'll come to find out, as we always do later on in the show, mm-hmm. About how this will come around to what we're talking about.